farm in the north of Tasmania near Deloraine. The farm's about 220 hectares and we have beef cattle, they're Angus and Shorthorns, and we've got about 300 or 400 of them depending on the time of year. The farm had previously been a blue gum plantation, so it was sown down to Italian ryegrass. We had to do a lot of reseeding, so we're getting to the end of that now and we're building up our cattle numbers. We'll have about 150 breeders and we fatten the progeny and we also buy in some extras too. Okay, we got involved in the Pasture Principal program because we needed to learn how to manage this sort of grass. We came from Queensland where we'd had tropical grasses and the management here is very different. It's much more intensive. Well, the process was pretty easy. I think we saw an ad in the newspaper. There was a course coming up and so we just rang up and signed up. We didn't know anyone in the district and it was great for us to meet a lot of other farmers and we learned a lot from them. In a way we were starting from scratch, but a long time ago we were dairy farmers in Scotland. That was about 25 years ago. So we had managed these sort of pastures then, but things have moved on a lot since then and we wanted to learn about the latest techniques. I think when we came here, we were just new here, it was a new farm. We had to do a lot of fencing. We had to put in water points and water pipelines and troughs and things. So by learning about rotational grazing techniques, it was a big help in how we set up the infrastructure. It's really a matter of taking one step at a time and developing as we went along. Each year we've seen an improvement and we've also learned a lot. As you know, year one, it's always more difficult with learning new techniques, particularly with the rotational grazing management, looking at the leaf stage of the grass, which is the basis for setting the rotation length. It takes a bit of time to learn how to do that and to be confident in it. I think I was surprised that it was possible to be so precise in feed budgeting, to be able to measure how much grass you've got, to be able to plan ahead for what growth rate you expect in the months coming up. You can be quite precise on how much feed you've got available, and then you can also be quite precise in how much feed you give to the animals. I'd say the other producers, you'd get involved. It's a great way of learning new techniques. You're never too old to learn.
I got involved in the PGS program because I've got a background in agronomy, keen interest in pastures and red meat production systems. So the opportunity to work with motivated, like-minded producers from a professional point of view is very satisfying, and going through that learning journey with them is a great thing to be involved with. Pasture Principles is very responsive to local conditions and issues. It has to be that way. We've got a common factor of the feed base, the grasses that we grow and the animals, but the variation associated with soils and water and climate and rainfall, and then are we dry land or irrigated? We have to be able to adapt and we have to be able to work with producers to meet their needs in that respect. Pasture Principles is all about building confidence. Without confidence, no one should make changes. So the reason why we're making decisions, the outcomes that we expect from making these decisions, if we don't do that, people can't change and they shouldn't change. The best advice I've got for you is make time, go out and challenge yourself. Everyone's got the opportunity to learn and do better. It could be a small thing, it could be a big thing, but go out there, make time, get off your property, get involved in these small groups, and you will enjoy it.